Hello dear otaku start friends, it's been ages, I'm absolutely sorry for this break, but it was out of my hands. I hope you're still loyal as you always have been. Anyways, we are back now, and you might say, oh yeah, here we go again. We will be enlightening your days and nights as we used to do before. You would be making us more than happy if you give us some feedback, and make us feel welcomed once again. I know it was a long time you didn't see us, but we have faith in you, and hoping that you're still amazing as we left you. However, today we are back with a list of the best 10 action fantasy manhwa. As you well, don't forget to subscribe to the channel, and if you are new here, like the video and subscribe too. Without any more details, let's start the list from number 10.
Updater. This new action fantasy manhwa is the one we chose for you to start by, and step by step you will discover more better ones. At least the majority of those recommendations will satisfy your lust for reading. Anyways, this manhwa is about a blacksmith in PC Aiden. Once the system moderator decided to delete his village completely, and he did, but when Aiden and his little sister Alice had perished, he took it upon himself and swore to take his revenge and destroy the system with his very hands. And it was just then Aiden unlocked moderator forms. He just woke up with a new power as the moderator level 1. So now he will start the journey all over again, and we shall see it all happening while reading this new action fantasy manhwa. On the other hand, the art is magnificent. Those new manhwas have some extraordinary art. Your eyes will be always safe looking at such beautiful art. Therefore, you have my permission to start reading this new manhwa, guys. Next, in number 9, the tutorial is too hard. This new action fantasy manhwa is about Lee Ho-ji. It was started on a very boring day, but sadly there is a message appeared. This message was inviting him to a tutorial, so he did join that tutorial and somehow chooses to escape it. But he just happened to choose the hardest possible difficulty. His choice was nothing else but hell itself. Such an unbelievable and unlucky decision he made. Anyways, now he shall experience all what he was running from. Moreover, what I like more about this new action fantasy manhwa is that the MC is unlike many other ones. He is not having that supreme character protagonist with extremely OP powers that allows him to defeat anyone. No, the MC here is getting hurt a lot, and he keeps trying. It is more of a realistic thing. This is what will make you like the pretty good storyline and the main character. Therefore, you will be waiting it just to update and continue reading. So do not skip this one, guys. It's worth your time. Down in number 8, Poison Dragon, The Legend of an Asura. The long history of the medical sect is followed by a complete and utter annihilation in a hellhole of despair, where corpses pile up like mountains and blood flows like the sea. This is just like a poetry about an ancient mythology. Anyways, it was then when finally Asura awakens, and she was determined to kill everyone, swearing that she won't be over till she kills every single one of them. The only survivor of the medical sect is Jin Jagang, and he swore to take and follow his vengeance too. However, you cannot get over the character building and background plot in this new fantasy action manhwa. If you are interested or looking for a story about a hero rising from nothing, you will have that in this manhwa, so be at ease. But you might like the villain too, because he is making the story really entertaining. Overall, the beginning of this new action fantasy manhwa is really nice, so let's just keep hoping that it keeps the same vibes. Down in number 7, Villain to Kill. I can't really say much or judge this action fantasy manhwa as for now, but I must say that the start of this manhwa is really intriguing. The MC is talented and he has a bit of hot-headed temper, but still has plenty of room to grow more powerful. Anyways, you have to become the greater evil to fight against the real evil. That's what happened to Kaizen after he died being framed of the murder of a comrade. And just when he thought it was all over for him, his soul is transferred to a young boy, a very popular top-class seeker who has everyone in V, turns into a villain overnight. This boy ended up going from seeker to villain. This thing is being explained, how it's even possible for someone to change from one to another, as that would require the blood composition to change, right? But sometimes you have to make some sacrifice to gain more powers. This boy is willing to enter the state of uncontrol to gain the powers he feels it's necessary to achieve his goals of vengeance and justice. Overall, you will like it, guys. Just go for it. Down in number 6, Arcane Sniper. The story of this new action fantasy manhwa is about Sergeant Ha. Just when he was at the army doing what he knows to do best, he was an amazing shooter, always shooting another full round of bullseyes. All what he ever wanted is to stay and be a part of the army forever. However, due to an unfortunate accident, he became paraplegic, and simply he was tossed back to society, and he was seeing his dream collapse before his eyes. On the other hand, the revolutionary VR game, Middle-earth, was presented a new life to him. so now he will be lucky to use his shooting skills once again. And what's more important is that this is a money obtained game. Middle-earth has real world value money, though he ruined his chance by selecting the lowest tier character. But in fact he was not an ordinary player, because with his army skills and being a shooting master, it would be just fine to start the game from the weakest points, because he will rise eventually and become the best. Overall, it is a good action fantasy manhwa, guys. You have to try it. Right in the middle, in number 5, the player that can't level up. This new action fantasy manhwa is seemingly really interesting. It really sends some solo leveling vibes, and I know you are still looking for such similarities in any manhwa you read. Anyways, the MC awakened as a player at the age of 18. He thought his life was on the track to success, climbing the tower and closing the gates. But wait a minute, it seems even after cleaning the tutorial he was still in level 1. He killed a goblin a day, and he was still in level 1. Even after 5 years, he was still just in level 1. Such a struggle indeed. Moreover, after such clear good beginning, we can only hope that this new man will keep up the good vibes till the end, because it's definitely amazing and has a lot of potential to raise up and be amongst the best in the future. Overall, the art is magnificent as usual. Nothing to say against the art. Those artists are just drawing so good. Therefore, we can only enjoy the good work. Down in number 4, The Second Coming of Gluttony, Part 2. The story in this new action fantasy manhwa is good. That's if you read the first part, of course, and that's a normal thing you can do. If you want to understand any story, you have to start reading it from the very beginning. Therefore, this is the second part. If you didn't read the first part yet, go back and start it over. Anyways, the story in this manhwa is giving some solo leveling feelings too. It's basically a mashup with Solo Leveling and Tower of God. Those two are without a doubt the best one out there. Therefore, you would be looking for any other manhwas that look like them. But you know you wouldn't find any, you just have to live with it. And from time to time you will come across such manhwas as this, in which you will feel some similar vibes. That's all what you can find. However, in this second part of this manhwa, the MC will meet his first comrades and learn to be a better person. That's all I can tell you about it, guys. It's up to you to read it or not.
Down in number 3, Return of the Frozen Player. Considering this new action fantasy manhwa, it could be holding what you like the most. It's an amazing manhwa, but if you are a fan of solo leveling, or you are willing to jump into this type of readings, this one could serve you quite well. Anyways, you will like the main character without any hesitations. Actually, it's the main reason why this manhwa went on the right path. Additionally, this manhwa has an interesting way to tell a story about gates, levels and skills. What's more is that the MC has a clear goal to reach, though there are some moments where the character feel a bit flat, or not as entertaining as they usually are. But no worries, the story and the great art makes up for it. Overall, if you are wondering about a good action fantasy manhwa to read and enjoy any afternoon tea, you have this one as one of the best recommendations you could possibly find. Next in number 2, The Constellation That Returned from Hell. It is not an easy task to find a good action fantasy manhwa to read, am I right? Otherwise you wouldn't be here looking for some, but for that reason we live to give you what you need, and hopefully we served you well enough. However, the MC in this new manhwa is quite amazing and familiar. When you look at him, you might say I've seen him somewhere. Well, if you have watched the anime Jujutsu Kaisen, you will know that the MC here looks just like Gojo-sensei, and that's a character built only to admire. On the other hand, the MC was enduring thousands of years in hell, but he finally was returned with the task to save all humanity. This action fantasy manhwa is simply amazing, beautiful with a good storyline, alongside such a decent character development. All this makes it a perfect choice to read. Therefore, I really recommend it for you guys. I'm sure it won't let you down. Finally, in number 1, Mokhyang, The Origin. Another great action fantasy manhwa that 2021 is happily provided for us. And the story of this new manhwa is happening during a turbulent time in the world of Miriam. Number 2044 was kidnapped as a child and brought to the demonic faction in order to train in the ways of assassination. After enduring all his harsh training and surviving till the end, he was able to earn the title Mokhyang. However, he always had an unstable thirst, and that was his desire for the sword. It was during this time that Mokhyang met his new master, Blade of Illusions, Yubik, which became a training point in his life. So now the question is, will Mokhyang be able to rise to the profound demonic realm that he has been aiming for all his life? Overall, it's a really good story, with a classical plot, but the way it is told is really original. Therefore, I really recommend this action fantasy for you, my dear friends. We have reached the end, and if you made it this far, you have one little thing to do, which is like the video and subscribe to the channel, and why not share it with your friends so that you make our days. Thank you for watching. See you next time.